Hey guys, so recently we picked up an old industrial robot arm for 500 bucks off Kijiji. We'd like to answer a few of the comments that we got in the last video where we showed bringing it home. First of all, the cost of the robot arm. Like I said, we paid $500 for it, which is actually quite incredible. When this robot first came out in 1990, it would have been worth between $500,000 and $1 million. Talk about depreciation. Now, $500 might seem like a lot of money to spend on something which could just be scrap and garbage. But look at it this way, even if we were to take it to the metal scrapyard, we could actually get more than $500 in scrap metal value alone. We might even be able to part out some of the servo motors and whatnot and make even more money off of it. Now obviously this could be quite the time intensive project. It could take hundreds of hours to fix it up and get it working again. But don't worry, we're not going to waste our time on it. We're going to strategically look at this and see if it's worth our time to fix up. Besides, absolute worst case, it would make a pretty awesome piece of lawn art. I'm quite happy to have paid $500 for something to put on my lawn.
Okay, well
then. Step one, we're gonna have to clean it a little bit. Its previous life was a foam injection molding machine and it is filthy. We're gonna have to clean it off to make sure we can actually locate all the different cables that need to go to the controller. If we can figure out how to plug it all in, the next step is testing the controller. Luckily, my neighbor has three-phase power in his shop, so we'll actually be able to turn on the controller and see if it still works. If that works, then we're going to try and connect the robot, and hopefully, it'll turn on. All right, so we got most of the main crud off of the robot and we're actually able to see all the wires now. We've taken a bit of time to actually evaluate where the wires go, and unfortunately some of the cables aren't even connected to that control panel in the bottom. Luckily, most of the cables were actually labeled, so we think we've actually found all the main access cables and the location to plug them into the controller. So, next step, let's try and turn this controller on.
Alright, three phases on. Holy crap.
Wow.
Oh!
Again.
error, no constant file. Select robot tag.
No, that's working.
This is a surprisingly good sign. Emergency stop doesn't seem to do anything. Alright, let's shut her down and when we have some more time. Transformer. Oh, that is one heavy
what?
Switch. It's Dan. Circuit breaker doesn't want to turn off. Whatever, we'll tell Dan. Alright, until next time, robot. Can't believe it turned on.
Alright, the controller actually turned on. That's incredible. It's older than I am, and it actually turned on still. Next step, we'll be getting the robot cables and actually getting the robot either down to Stan's garage or getting three-phase power up here. We're not too sure yet. Luckily, one of my friends from high school, his dad actually runs a used robotics shop. And he said we can come take a look and see if he has any cables that would work with this robot. So there's a good chance we can save some money there by getting free cables to plug it all together. His company's called New Age Robotics, and you should totally look him up. Assuming we can find the right cables for the robot and we're actually able to plug the two together, then we'll be able to see if the controller still works. If it does, awesome. If it doesn't, we can spend a bit of time troubleshooting to see if we can get it to work, but honestly, the chances of it working if it doesn't work right now are pretty slim. Which only leaves us a few options. We can scrap the entire controller and try and use an open source controller instead, but again, this could take a lot of time. Or we can scrap out the parts and make our money back on the robot. Now, if there's anyone in our audience who's interested in working on a project like this, let us know, and you can actually sign the volunteer form on our website if you're interested in trying to help get this robot working. We've already had a few people reach out, including a Nachi service tech from the US, who's provided us with some documentation on the robot, which has really helped so far. That being said, we hope these videos on us attempting to fix it up will be educational and instructional for anyone else trying to do something similar. And we're hoping maybe having these videos will get some interest from some actual robotics companies, and maybe we'll actually get a robotics sponsorship so we can have a working robot in the shop. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you're notified as soon as this next video goes live. Thanks for watching.